What's up, everybody? It's Kelsey Rihanna J here with my November favorites.
And honestly, this year, it flew by ridiculously fast. And I think it's because I'm getting older that my concept of time has changed. And not that I didn't appreciate life before, but now that I get older, I just cherish every moment that I have with everyone, and I'm just way more appreciative and just aware of time and how precious it is and how short of time we actually have on this earth. Now, I have a few products that I want to share with you all for my favorites. Honestly, November, December, and January are probably the slowest months I have to buy stuff, and I know that that is crazy, but I just feel like November is the month for sales, and things that I've already purchased previously throughout the year, they just all go on sale, so I already have it, so I don't spend a lot of money on makeup in November. And then December, I pretty much like buy maybe a few like little holiday things. Maybe one or two companies will come out with something new, but overall it's not a whole lot of stuff. But I have been enjoying the things that I grabbed to share with you all in this video, so let me just go ahead and jump right into that. So I shared with you guys in one of my recent videos that I recently got Invisalign. Since it has gotten colder and I have started wearing Invisalign, my lips have been extremely chapped. I don't know if it's how I hold my mouth with the plastic or whatever, but my lips are extremely chapped. So I have really, really gone hard with the chapstick. I've really been loving this Christian Dior Creme de Rose lip balm. I've had this product for quite some time now, so it's not new. It's just I didn't use it as much, but I absolutely love the way it feels. I love rose scented products, so of course that's always gonna win for me. The only downfall is that it's a scooper, and you guys know, well, you, I don't know, some of you might know, some of you might not know, I'm a germaphobe, so it's like anything germy is like But I absolutely love this. Aside from that, I wish that they would put this same exact formula in a squeeze tube, and I would love them forever. But this feels amazing. It's so moisturizing. It feels so luxurious on your lips. It makes your lips silky smooth, and I absolutely love it. Definitely one of my favorite lip balms, and I've been heavily utilizing this. Next, I have worn the same two blushes all month. Like, it's pretty ridiculous. And the first one that I have had in constant rotation is this NARS blush in the color Gina. And it's this really pretty, just muted peachy color. This is just one of the perfect blushes that I've been wearing for fall. It goes with all of my warm tone looks, and it's a gorgeous, gorgeous blush. They do not sell this blush in Sephora. I ordered mine from Barney's, but they also sell it on Neiman Marcus as well as NARS.com, just not Sephora. And they also sell this at Nordstrom.com. Next, I have been absolutely loving this even more than I did when it first released. This is the Whisper of Guilt Nutcracker Sweet Copper Face Compact. It has Whisper of Guilt and then the Extra Dimension blush in the color Pleasure Model. I have that on right now pretty lightly, but oh my gosh, this is like the best invention ever. I would love if MAC did like the duos like this all the time, because this was perfect for me traveling so much this month. I use this even more than I use my original Whisper of Guilt compacts, and I love the combination. This looks so beautiful on the cheek, and you can sheer it out or you can make it more intense, but I absolutely love this, and I hate that I didn't get a backup, but I have been living for this. My skin has been insanely dry. Every time the seasons change from either cold to hot or hot to cold, my skin goes through like a severe reaction to it. So I added a facial oil, and you guys probably saw me pick this up in my Sephora VIB haul, but this is the Drunk Elephant Virgin Marula Luxury Facial Oil, and it is marula oil. So I have been using this every single day in conjunction with some of my other products, and I love it. This is exactly what my skin was needing. This is what I was missing. This gives my skin that extra it makes my skin look that much more healthy and glowy and radiant, and I absolutely love this. This is high in antioxidants, omega 6 and 9, and it is unrefined oil. It is pure pure marula oil, and it doesn't have any additives, no fillers, it's straight to the point. Drunk Elephant is such an amazing line because they are just super, super natural. They don't go for the foo-foo, they don't go for what smells good, and I absolutely love the line. I've been mixing a few drops of this oil in with my moisturizer, and it has been absolutely lovely, and I will continue to use this until forever until my skin no longer gets the same reaction. That's when I'll stop using it, but this is exactly what the doctor ordered. Not literally, but I needed this. Next, ever since I did the MAC haul of the In the Spotlight collection with the new Extra Dimension skin finishes, as well as the strobe cream extensions, this one has been in constant rotation. I actually think it's about to be empty. This one is the gold light strobe cream, and I've been mixing this with my foundation, wearing it underneath my foundation, and it has given such beautiful results. My skin really reacts when the weather changes, so it's been just looking dull and I needed a boost. So this right here gives me such a beautiful lip from within look, and it definitely makes my skin look glowier and more healthy, and I absolutely love strobe cream. So for me to not want to buy this palette and then go on to buy the palette just for my channel and then go on to really, really love the palette is kind of rare for me. This one is the Huda Beauty Texture Eyeshadows Palette, the Rose Gold Edition, and I know you guys are probably sick to death of seeing this palette. I did a review on this palette, and then I did a comparison video comparing this palette to the Modern Renaissance palette, as well as the Natasha Denona Star palette. But honestly, this palette has been with me all month when I traveled, whenever I just did my makeup. This palette, I've literally used it every day this month, and I haven't even gone in my collection to even reach for another eyeshadow palette, because this one is just the one that I've been using to do basic everyday looks, to do dramatic looks. Honestly, I've been kind of going for the dramatic looks every day. So every single day I beat my face, and I've grown to really love it, and I've really mastered using these 3D metal eyeshadows, and I absolutely love this palette. It's so gorgeous, and I have it on my eyes now. This is the only palette that I use to do my eyes. Guys, I probably won't do any more tutorials using this eyeshadow palette just because I feel like it's just becoming too much. Like, it's time out, it's time to move on, but I definitely will still be using it in my everyday life. So I have absolutely loved this contraption since I purchased it. This is the Troy Surratt eyelash curler. This eyelash curler has been on my wish list for about a year and a half at this point. And every time I see it in Sephora, I always walk past it. I know exactly where it is in my Sephora. I always say next time, because I really wear lashes a lot. So I'm like, do I really need an eyelash curler? Is it really going to make that big of a difference? But eyelash curlers that I have worked with in the past were in comparison to this. This is like the Cadillac, the Rolls Royce, the Hermes of eyelash curlers. This definitely gives me volume and curl and lift to my lashes, and it makes them look more girly and feminine, and it's absolutely amazing, and it does not take that much effort. And I definitely recommend this for anybody who is on the market for a new eyelash curler. And honestly, I was surprised that this eyelash curler sold out during the sale, because I have not heard anybody talk about it. And all of a sudden, like the day after I purchased it, it was out of stock. So that really surprised me, especially considering that this isn't a new tool, but it was sold out, and it is still sold out on Sephora.com. But I definitely recommend signing up to be notified when it's restocked. This foundation is absolutely amazing right now for my skin, because my skin, honestly, I don't think my skin has ever been as dry as it has been right now. And this is the La Mer, the Soft Fluid Longwear Foundation. And I did a review on it, and we know that this foundation is expensive, but honestly, I can wear 10 different, like, this is what happened. So over Thanksgiving, I was around to my family and I did my makeup in a fresh way about 4 or 5 times. So like, I would wake up and do my makeup, and then my cousins and stuff would want to go out at night, so I would do my makeup over because it has, you know, worn throughout the day. I wore this foundation 2 or 3 times out of the 5 times that I did my makeup. Like, 2 times I knew I wasn't going anywhere but just around the house, so I didn't wear this because it's expensive. But the times that I did, like, my guy cousins who wouldn't ever notice were like, your skin looks so pretty. It's like, what? I'm like, so did you think that earlier? They were like, I mean, we didn't really think anything about it earlier. And so for them to be able to notice the difference in my skin when I wear this foundation just goes to show how amazing this foundation is. And you know, La Mer is very famous for their Miracle Broth, which I don't know the entire story, but this is just from memory. Basically, the inventor, somebody was burned and he went and found a Miracle Broth. It was like bead or kelp or something like that, and he patented, he put that technology into all of the products. Something like that. I have to do further research and like really perfect the story. So I have been absolutely loving this Sephora Contour Rouge Gel Lip Liner, and I have the color, what color? 15 Rosewood. Oh my goodness. This is so amazing. It's literally a gel lip liner. So it's not the traditional pencil, it's not dry. It's very moisturizing, very creamy, and it's a really fun consistency. So I've been loving it. It screws up, it screws down. You don't have to worry about sharpening it. The only thing that worries me about screw up and screw down lip liners is that they do tend to dry out quicker. But at the rate that I've been using this product, honestly, I don't really have to worry about it drying up before I use it because it's the perfect color for me. I've been wearing it on a daily basis. It's been in my purse. I've worn it all over my lips before with just a little bit of lip balm, and it was just a beautiful, beautiful color. So here it is. You see how that just glides on? So this product was a forgotten treasure. When I first bought it, it was definitely a love for me, but honestly, I just forgot that I had it. This is the Hourglass Brilliant Strobe Lights powder. I think the color is brilliant. This is the ambient strobe lighting powder, and this was kind of like, I purchased this like in the strobing phase where that was just super, super popular, and I picked up this one. This one is like a more subdued highlighter. It is like more natural even though it's bright, so it's going to give that lit from within look, and it's not going to be super, super iridescent. It's just going to look glowy all over, and I love this. I've been wearing this a lot because I've been really a big fan of just natural skin. Like right now, this is probably the most foundation and concealer and all this stuff like that that I've worn in a minute, because I've just been really, really loving more natural skin. I mean, I still have turned up on my eyes. Like my eyes have been really super turned like this past month, but as far as skin goes, like I really am into that healthy skin look, and so this is what I've been using. So lastly, these eyeshadows have definitely made their way into my heart. These are my Makeup Geek eyeshadows that I purchased. I purchased 2 bundles that she offered for the fall, and I have absolutely loved these eyeshadows, and I feel like the formula is so phenomenal. They are definitely worth the hype. My first experience with Makeup Geek eyeshadows was the Manny MUA palettes, and I was like, if a palette's quality is that great, then I know her individual eyeshadows are. So I'm 100% going to expand on my collection, but this is my starting point. I'm excited to get more of these eyeshadows. The formula is amazing. I know a ton of you guys asked me, like, are these better than MAC eyeshadows? Like, what are my thoughts comparing them? And if you guys want me to do a separate video on that, then it will be a minute, because I definitely want to take my time and explore more of the Makeup Geek eyeshadows. Because although I have had a great experience with these, I see a few eyeshadows that could be comparable to MAC eyeshadows, but not enough for me to make an entire video on it. But so far, I definitely have been loving these eyeshadows, and dare I say, I almost prefer I don't know. It's right there. But I've really been loving these eyeshadows. I don't know. That's all I have to share. I don't have any music favorites, any TV favorites. Like, nothing has been really interesting or popping out to me that is interesting enough for me to share. So tell me what some of your favorites are down in the comments section. As always, I love to know what you guys' favorites are, especially if it's something different than what I have. And if you know you haven't seen me use a product that you've been loving on your channel, then I love to go buy and try new stuff. Y'all know that. But let me know down in the comments section. And if you have not already, please subscribe. That way you keep in touch. Oh, my voice is going out. As well as follow me on my other social media accounts. That way you can keep up with me when I'm not on YouTube. But I will talk to you all very, 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 very soon, because I have so many new videos to get out to you guys. And I will talk to you all later. Smooches. Bye.